So for 20-something years now, Bad Buddies have been needing mannequins of all types to just display their suits. You know, this is a bad year for us now. We're not costuming very much. We need a place to put things. This was my mannequin that I first did back in about 1992, early 93, and I made a few other mannequins just to display in my house, in my office, before my children were around. And then I said, I gotta get rid of these things. They're just gonna scare the kids. Well, I made another mannequin that was a foam, flexible mannequin. I thought, okay, here's the answer to everything. And it is, really. But I just couldn't make it economically enough. So I only made a few of them. And I have the mold and everything. I can make them for my needs. But I really can't offer them because they require over a day each to make. And then you get material costs. But they're great because they're Luke Perry. He's a good size. It's a regular average individual. I'm much taller, so it's good to have a regular size individual for a mannequin as a model. And that's why I used it. They're filled with soft, flexible foam, and inside each one, I can either place rebar or conduit pipe or some other type of thing that you can bend and force all the proportions to go as it needs to. And the head, of course, everything's soft. You can get it into a cowl real easily. There you go. And it just pops right back into place. Everything is nice and flexible and usable for so many different types of Batman uses for their costumes. And you could pose them any way you want, because I found that mannequins that were available at the time, they were always either in a really stiff military pose or some feminine kind of like, ha, look at me pose. So I said, okay, let's do this. I tried a few just to show how they can be dressed up, and I realized after Indiana Jones here, and this is all generic stuff. I was trying to make generic mannequins. This isn't even the real stuff, okay? It's just a cheap Indiana Jones hat, a non-correct jacket, a cheap Mexican whip, just an old pair of my chinos and some old work boots. There's Rick O'Connell. I put a wig on him. That is my, or one of my props that I did there, the dual shoulder holster. But what happened was when I put these out at a convention even, and this one here, Batman Begins, just made from various things that I'd collected. What happened is, they wouldn't even go for hardly more than the price of the mannequin. I said, well, I can't do that. That's ridiculous. Not worth my time. So I said, okay, I'm going to make a mannequin for my uses. And that's what these things are. And now I'll talk a little bit about how I did that.
You need major seam work. Oh, hey, Bat Buddies. Paul Roberts here. More surgery today, but I went traipsing through my stuff. I went up in the attic. I found it. I just didn't have the props. Went and found this old dusty mask. Man, they're hard to find these days. So I'm gonna prepare to do some more surgery here, and then I'm gonna tell you how I make a mannequin like this. Get ready here. Ah, yes. Scalpel. Thank you. So we've gone around and I've gotten all the seams worked out. Yeah. I can't work under these conditions. I just wanted to come across, you know, the right way, you know, like a surgeon. Hey! Basically, what I do here is I'm going and taking, I've attached this limb. I've done a few restructural things. And I'm taking a resin, instead of fiberglass resin, I'm using the resin that I have. And I'm connecting the things like this and doing some repairs. Then I'm gonna sand the whole thing down, as I said the other day in the other mannequin video, and take off various, whatever I have to, and then reprime and get him ready to be looking his best again. Maybe I'll paint the face. I don't know. If it's Luke, it might as well look like Luke, right? I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna use this as a prop to just describe what I did to make my mannequin. Okay, you gotta remember, guys, I'm a hobbyist. You gotta remember, I don't do things the correct way. I do the things the way that I have to do them. So I'm not necessarily gonna tell you the most professional way. I'm out here in Hollywood. I could go easily, go over and get a job over with Ironhead Studios or whatever, or work on the films, but I don't do that. I do everything by myself. Now, they do everything properly over there, and that's great. There's a place for that. But in my life, you got to remember, I just wanted a bat suit, okay? I was doing professional video production and working in films and things like that. I did all my stuff on the side before I ever knew anybody else in the world ever wanted a bat suit besides me. Then I went into renovating houses and things like that, and I was only doing this on the side. So it wasn't until I became, you know, kind of like well-known throughout the world as doing this stuff that I finally said, okay, well, I'm going to do this officially on these videos and talk to the Bat Buddies directly, you know, and take it off a message board and make it more live and, you know, welcoming and hands-on. But this is more recent. Well, in the early days, I had to have the things that I needed to work. And you just couldn't go get them. I had to make them. So what did I do to make a mannequin? Okay. You're going to laugh. You're going to laugh. But I had Alfred come over. He's my only guy. And I had some plaster bandages. And we had gone to some auctions and things like that. And one time when the auction was just about ending, I go, there's this great big roll of cellophane or whatever. I guess it's cellophane, yeah. He goes, lifetime supply of cellophane. Do I have any bids? I said, yeah, I could use a lifetime supply of cellophane. Sure, why not? $10. Got it. I still got it in the outer recesses of the cave right now, and I use it for all kinds of things. But what I did was I basically laid down on the floor, okay? I laid down on the floor. This isn't the way to do it. But when you don't have a crew, and you just have to make something happen for yourself, this is when I was going to make the muscle suit, okay? I laid down on the floor, and I spread my legs and my arms farther than they normally would be for a mannequin, because I wanted to be able to get up underneath the crotch area and around underneath the arms and work. And I knew what I was doing. I was going to make a muscle suit. And I said, would you please lay down plaster bandages once I was all cellophaned up and everything over top of me? And he did. So I'm sitting there laying with plaster bandages on top of me, waiting long enough, holding my pose for them to dry. And then I went ahead and took that off. It held its shape pretty well. But now I needed to do my back. How was I going to do my back? Well, what I did was I went ahead and did a fiberglass form over those plaster bandages so that it was nice and hard, okay? Then the next step was to do the back. So I laid that form down on the ground, I laid in it upside down, and I had him do the same treatment to the back, plaster bandages. Then after he was done with that, I said, thank you very much, you've assisted me. Didn't take very long to do it. It wasn't the right way to do it, but it worked. I took that and I made a fiberglass form of the back half. When that was done, I shaved down the seams, put it back together, did my measurements, making sure it was all the right dimensions of each limb at the seam area and torso and everything, and then just fiberglass that together. And that's just a crude inner mannequin so that when I make my muscle suits and I fill it with foam, it only makes the foam for the outer part where it touches where all the muscles are, and it doesn't make the form for the inner part that you're going to slip into. So I did that for a good period of time with that mannequin. So it's just totally functional. Now the mannequin, just be warned, if you lay down, you're going to be flatter, just because gravity is going to take you, okay? So what you want to do is, if you join them together, you want to give yourself a little bit more room at that seam so that you're made less flat, if that's important to you. Mine was going to be under a foam muscle suit, and the foam and the muscle suit would change so that when you're in it and you're not as flat, it pushes back out to the regular thing. And I was going to be the only person that it would work perfect for, but anybody else could use it by just simply taking out a few inches under the belt and shrinking it down, as long as you weren't too small. I mean, even me, I look like a Hulk almost, like one of those big muscle Batmans. So it was only for a certain type of a look. But I ended up using it for all kinds of other things for other people, monsters and things like that. And even now I could do other things, but I just focus on Batman because that's what I'm interested in. But that's how I did my mannequin. And you could do that too. There's one other really inexpensive way to do a mannequin. Go to Home Depot, buy some of that PVC pipe or whatever for sprinkler systems, some of that glue, link them together, make a little skeletal thing standing up, take newspaper and wrap it around there. You can't even get newspapers anymore. I used to have it. You could take this brown paper, you could whatever you need to get the bulk. And then just wrap it in duct tape. And then you can build up, once it's built up, you can go ahead and do the last layers of duct tape a little more smoothly, but you're not gonna see it's gonna be under a bat costume. And then you can put your bat costume on it. That's what you can do. Those are the easy ways to make mannequins. I just thought I'd do a video on that while I'm working on Luke here. And that's today's video. I've got nothing more to say on that. But thank you for asking about it, because now I thought, oh, somebody wants to see. Well, you know what? For a while, I'm gonna say, oh, somebody wants to see, even if there's one or two people that say it. Eventually, I'm hoping that there's so many people and they're all asking for things, I say, I just can't do it. One bad buddy the other day asked, can you please give a full list of all the things you do to make this? And I can't. Even though I've done so many things in this hobby, if I give away everything about everything that I've learned myself that is just my own thing, then I'm going to be fighting just to make the hobby lucrative enough, just like I did with this mannequin. Couldn't make it happen because nobody wanted to finance it to be made. Again, I apologize for that, but there are certain things that are just me, and I'll try to focus on other things that we can all relate to, but there's certain things that are just me, and I've spent a lifetime developing and for now, those will be just the way they are. One day when I go into my retirement, and it could be soon, I hope it is, then I'll just go ahead and say, oh, everything else just go out, and there it is, and we'll talk about it all, but I don't want that to be right now because I'm still keeping this hobby going for a while, and I'd like to keep this channel going for a while, and one of the ways to make that happen is to have you guys comment and be interested and share it and get more people to do it, because what I'm already doing is I'm saying, okay, I can't do do-it-yourself videos every day because that's made just for this, and I'm going to do more videos of just what I'm doing, and they're going to be like less interesting, and they're going to be maybe not even appropriate for what you're doing, and that could hurt the channel because who's going to watch them? And I understand all these things, but I have to do what I have to do out of necessity. Just like how I made that mannequin laying down on the ground with plaster bandages. Everything I do in my whole life has always been like that. Creative, out of necessity, doing what you need to do to make something happen. And that gives me a wealth of experience and knowledge and wisdom to impart on others, but it also limits me. Because if I can't make it lucrative in a way that it can actually do something to sustain itself, then it fizzles away and dies. So, that's my thoughts on that today and for this channel. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. This is Behind the Mask. Thanks, Bat Buddies. Nice talking to you. Thank you for your interest. And I've got to go back to work. Man, I wish these things were more readily available. I wouldn't have to use these old dusty, moldy old masks. But now, this won't hurt a bit.